Now let's actually hop to our testing machines, to our VCOM 1 and our VCOM 2, our Resident Evil and Tomb Raider PC, and let's see how we can add some routing there to connect to the internet. And just to add a bit more on routing, I am currently trying to reach my ESXi host that is running at the IP address 10.32.12.3. But as you can see, I'm not getting any connection. Why is that? Let me actually bring up my routing table and let's actually rerun this command because I'm currently having a few more routes because I have just connected my network. Now let's actually try to resolve this 10.32.12.0. Let's try that. 10, 10, 10, 10. Okay, 10.32, but 11. We just have 10.32.11.101 because my networking adapter, all my networking is going through a firewall. And this firewall is listening at the 10.32.11.1 address, but we are trying to reach a 10.32.12.3. So as you can see, we don't have any 12 address here, so any address is going to be routed to a default gateway. And as you can see, we currently have two default gateways, and this default gateway here is currently prioritized, so we're actually going to go through the Fritzbox, and the Fritzbox is not able to fulfill the request to 10.32.12.0 or 12.3. The Fritzbox is not able, the Fritzbox doesn't know this address, so what I need to do is I need to manually add myself a route to my own ESXi host. This is not ideal, and in a real network you would do this kind of like different, but I'm just gonna do this manually here, so I'm gonna add a route here to 10.32.12.0 to the full subnet, and this is gonna go over the gateway at 2.10.32.11.1. So I have mistyped something, so there we go. And as you can see, I need some more permissions here. This command is actually requiring some administration access, so let me open up an admin CMD and let's just retype this: route at 10.32.12.0 mask 255.255.255.0.10.32.11.1, and boom, it says okay. So we have properly added a route here, and if I would list them now, you would see that I have this 10.32.12.0 route for the full subnet, and as you can see that it is gonna go through the gateway at 10.32.11.1 at the 10.32.11.101 gateway networking card. And routing, these routes that I'm gonna add with this route add will be cleared every time our system restarts. You can also add static routes. This is a static route that I have added. This is why it's up here, but it's not gonna, it's not been hitted. I actually would need to clear the static route at some point, and it would ideally add this route as a static route as well. But I'm just gonna do this when we are getting to a final system, and I'm gonna know that this IP address and this gateway address gonna be persistent. And if I would now try to refresh the web page, you can actually see that now I'm getting some information here, and I can connect to my ESXi host, which is basically hosting all these virtual machines. I can boot these virtual machines up and I can open them up in a new register card. I'm always doing this with both of them. So I'm going to open this up in a new register card, and then I just tend to pop one out, move them aside, refresh them until the screens are looking good. Not looking good as now. They need a few refreshes so that the display is not resized. So right. And now I can log into these machines. And you're gonna see that we have the Resident Evil PC at the wrong side. It was other way around. There we go. Now it has made it wrong and wrong again. Let's refresh until I get full size. There we go. Now we have opened up our VCOM 1, our Resident Evil PC, and our VCOM 2, our Tomb Raider PC. We're gonna try again to reach Google here. Let's see. And as you can see, we are not able to reach Google. Now let's configure our networks with both of these machines so that we can actually reach Google. So we're gonna go just click on this this tab here, say wired connect and wired settings, and it will automatically open up the correct tab in our settings. Now I can click on the Cox again and I can go to IPv4. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna manually type in a DNS server because I wanna use a Google DNS. There are things like DHCP that can automatically give us a DNS server, a IP address, a netmask, a gateway that can do this all automatically. We're going to talk about this in the future, but for now we're going to do this fully manual. Now let's also add the default gateway, which is listening at 10.32.1.1. Let's hit apply here, let's restart the network, and let's try to reconnect to Google. And I can, maybe it will not work. Yes, it's not working. This is just because, like, my full system. And currently what I'm gonna do, what I'm doing here is I'm sharing my wireless network to my testing network. And Windows has a bug there, or what is it? It's not a bug. It should start up automatically, but these are like Linux machines, and so the automatic startup is actually not working for this shared network, and I just need to re-enable this and accept this, and then it's gonna refresh the network. And if I would try to reach this now, it should work. And it didn't work, but this is something that you don't need to be considered of why this didn't work. This is just because I have a firewall connected that is also blocking the access, but by changing the settings that I have just done and refreshing that page, brings up our freshly Google page, and we could look for Ludwig Fusel. And we would find my YouTube channel. I can click on my YouTube channel, and I could watch my own videos here in my VCOM. I created the game in 24 hours using DirectX 12. So this is all working good. Let's now try this out at the different machine, which now crashed, which is something that might work, happen, but we don't get anything here yet. I need to manually go in and do the same settings here as well. So let's manually choose this DNS server where I'm going to use the Google DNS. And I'm going to manually type in the gateway. And if I apply this now and restart the network, we should also get a Google page here. And now let's search my channel here as well on the second computer. And you can see, boom, I can like now simultaneously watch two videos in virtual machines. So for example, like a modern GX tutorial and C++ multithreading. Amazing. Let's watch them all simultaneously. This is always good. But yeah, just to show you that our other stuff is still working, let's quickly ping our 10.32.1.102, our VCOM2. This is still working. We still can communicate with our VCOM2, obviously, because like we just had a default route where it was routing everything that was not working. And what we can also do, we can also ping from the VCOM2 our VCOM1, also working like a charm. So everything still good, what we have done in the EPv4 video. So they all still have their own addresses. Everything is looking good here. So yeah, we have now correctly set it up a default gateway, which automatically implies routes. Actually, let's also show the routes here on Linux. We can on Linux just type in route, and we're gonna get the routing table, which is actually looking a bit bad. It's having this gateway underscore gateway, but I cannot. I'm not currently seeing a proper gateway, so it's looking a bit different here on Linux. And also the gateway is not resolved, but basically where this default route just means connect to the default or setup gateway of that interface for the default destination. So this is just our default gateway setting here, and this is just our subnet here on Linux. It's looking a bit different. Can we actually find a bit more? Let's actually, no, we're gonna use our VCOM2 to find the comment for our VCOM1. So Linux show route, routing table. So how can we do this? We can do this with netstate. Okay, I just mistyped this, so let's type it in again. And now we are presented with something that looks a bit more similar to what we got on Windows. So we have this anycast address, or this any address 0 with a mask of 0, which is being routed to the gateway at 10.32.1.1. We have our 10.32.1.0, so our subnet of the current IP address that is just gonna go through no gateway with our subnet mask at our interface here. And we have this 169.254, which is also like a special address that is being broadcasted, and not a Linux expert, I'm more a Windows expert, but yeah, at least we got like the two important stuff, the two important routes that we need for actually communicating. We have the route to our own network, which is going to be the route when we ping the VCOM2, and we have the route, the any route that is going to go to our gateway that is then going through the internet. So yeah, everything working here as expected. We now have internet at our VCOM computers, which is very nice. So yeah, thank you for watching. In the next video, what are we going to do in the next video? I'm not quite sure. I think we're going to talk a bit about protocols. So yeah, thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Have a nice day. Make sure to like and subscribe. And yeah, bye.